Good afternoon, guys. Welcome back to another video. If you don't know already, we are here in the Philippines. We're just going to, I don't really know what the plan is for today, but just kind of walk around, get some pictures, as we usually do.
As we do.
Yes, always good capturing the streets of the Philippines. Hello. Just because they're so friendly. And we're also trying out our new, it's gonna get a little bit loud, our new gimbal for the first time. We haven't gotten a chance to try this out properly since Feiyutech sent it to us. It's the G6 Plus. We're just gonna try it out today. I'm excited to see what, it's just such a cool device. I love it.
Now, it's not the greatest camera, obviously.
Yeah.
We can't fit our big boy camera on it because it's too
That's
heavy.
That's the problem. So yeah, our main camera is a little bit heavy for this particular gimbal, so hopefully when we upgrade this camera, it'll just be a normal part of our everyday equipment. So yeah. Oh, first, coffee?
Yeah.
Coffee.
I was trying to take one of that woman who was walking directly towards me and be conspicuous by I held it down low. I think I might have got it. Sometimes you just know people walking towards you probably don't want their pic took, and I assumed that she was one of those people. Nope, no good.
It takes Chris a little while to get into his flow of taking pictures.
Well, I mean, some days it does and it's a little frustrating at the start, but you just have to roll with it. I'm a little rusty, I think. Taking a while. Did you get one?
I don't know. This one's kind of cool because I didn't realize he had bare feet. I obviously didn't even notice that, but I just seen it after I took the picture and you can just see his bare feet.
Whoa, wrong way. Still getting used to this gimbal.
Might work, not sure.
I'll keep going. Get the shot.
Always the way.
It took too long, I'm afraid. Did you get one?
No, I don't think so.
We're both a little rusty, I don't know why. Can you explain?
No. it just takes time sometimes to get into the groove. Kind of get your eyes back into the kind of photography mindset.
Yeah, very true. But sometimes I just don't get shots for like an hour and then I feel like I lost it.
Yeah, then you don't want to do the video anymore.
Yeah. You did?
I'm trying to frame it with the plants underneath. And then there's also a little plant that sticks up here, and then there's also a sign that's here, so I'm kind of like trying to fit everything in the right.
Somebody is trying to get those sweet grams out there.
Salt of the gram.
We just stopped in for a little coffee here in Toby's because it's kind of what we like to do to split up our photography routine. Not going too planned today, but that's just the way it is. Sometimes you go out of items now. You see the shots, you get them. And other days, it just doesn't come together. I mean, we might have more. At the minute, we don't know. We might have more than we think. I feel like I may have got possibly two, and that's about it. We did want to touch on just the fact that anybody taking pictures wherever you are in the world, we would highly recommend coming to really anywhere in Southeast Asia, but the cities, anywhere in Asia in general. We're currently, like we said, here in Makati, which is Metro Manila in the Philippines, and besides today,
thank you.
Oh yeah, that's not all for you. Yeah, as I was saying, we've explored around the streets of a lot of different cities, including Canada. We didn't do photography when we were in London, but there's just so much goes on in the streets here, and in pretty much every city here in Asia, it seems like Bangkok is ridiculous for street photography. Where else have we been? Vietnam's the same. Seoul's just a lot more going on. I think there's a lot more.
It's like just a completely different, like,
there's a different vibe, completely different world. And I think there's just more going on in the streets,
yeah.
Like more markets, more like Seoul has street dancers. When do you ever see that? And like even in America or the UK. So I would definitely recommend, if you're into your street photography, you want to get some cool shots and just experience something new, definitely come to cities, whether it's here in the Philippines, Tokyo, Japan, wherever, Seoul, Korea, wherever it is, it's a cool experience. Thank you. Thank you.
Enjoy. Thank you.
Sorry. Joking. And banana bread.
You could literally find like the most random things happening on the street, like,
that's
on
the
side of the road. You could see literally anything. Somebody selling something really strange, or
that's the thing, and that's
anything.
That's why we love doing the videos we do. We're going to do more like this, where it's more of a photography vlog, and also the POV videos, where it's just kind of uncut, us wandering around. And I think it really shows just how much is actually going on. Yeah, it's good fun. I would definitely recommend coming to cities on this, literally this side of the world, or at least this area. Asia, Southeast Asia, it's just very interesting and good fun to take pictures of.
Now can we eat?
Hey, what's going on here? What were you going to say?
The sun makes me sneeze.
It does. Every time you come out, ridiculous, you just sneeze.
I don't have coronavirus. We are still trying to get the hang of this thing, our new gimbal. I think it will take a little bit more practice.
Definitely.
To like get used to, because we never use a gimbal, we've never had one before, this is our first one, so. But I think when we figure out what's what, it will be such a handy thing to have with us all the time. And the reason they sent us this one is because it's the universal one, so it works with camera, mobile, action cam, and it's compact as well. So for us, it's good for travel. Any thoughts? We're fed, we've had coffee, now we're gonna try and get a few more pics. Because it's golden hour, baby!
Sure is.
Best time of the day. Let's go. I can't see a thing. Did you finally get one?
That is what I call shot of the day for me.
Yay.
But what I didn't notice when I was taking the low angle was there's also, if you can zoom into it, no parking anytime, tow sign right where he's parked.
Oh yeah, right there.
Not something I actually noticed, but those type of things for me just make shots, because it looks like I intentionally did it, which I will say that I actually did.
Yes. Are you using this to frame?
I sure am.
Some good tunes on. I like your tunes, my friend.
Okay, so definitely one of my favorite type of shots I'm about to try. It's the good old pan shot. I always try these in pretty much every video, and I tend to get at least one I like, so let's give it a go. Shot her down to 1/40, center focus, and I'll put the aperture up a little bit, so bright. See what I can get.
If you are ever in the Philippines doing some street photography, you will notice that Filipinos absolutely love the camera. Sometimes they'll even like turn around and like smile for you or pose for you. They might even ask you to take a picture. Oh, I almost missed the green man. They might even ask like, will you take my picture, take a picture of me? It's just one thing about Filipino people, it's just that they love the camera. So
what are you talking about?
If you're ever here in the Philippines, try and get pictures if you're doing street photography without them like seeing you first, because then you capture that candid moment. But if they see you, they'll probably like turn around and smile or do a pose at the camera lens, because they do just love pictures.
Okay, so finally, after a little bit longer than usual, I think we're getting into the flow, would you agree? It takes a little while, like we always say. It takes a little while to get into your flow. We're in an area with not as much going on. We're actually in Legazpi Village, for you guys from the Philippines, you'll know it. Getting some shots and still kind of getting used to this bad boy. Anyway, I think we've got some cool shots. You've definitely got a few in the last like 10 minutes. And I've got one, which I'm really happy with,
one.
I think. That's the goal. Let me go out and take these. I think if you come back with one to two pictures that you're really happy with that you could add to a little collection, then yeah. I think that's pretty successful. Mm-hmm. And that was the end of that. We pretty much finished up the shooting session right there.
And it is a brand new day, but we thought we would, before we finish this video, kind of look back and maybe pick what our favorite picture of the day was.
Yeah, picture of the day. Don't mind, we're wearing the same clothes, by the way, but that's...
I don't think you are.
That's, I believe I am. That's the travel life. Anyway, yeah, our favorite pick from the day. I kind of said it during the video because I just knew when I got this one that it was gonna be my favorite, because I think it was the best shot I got, and that was the one of the guy on the moped sitting with his foot against the curb and the little sign saying no parking, just because I actually had a little time to take it, set it up, and I just think it was probably one of the sharpest ones, and I like the edit on it the most. So that's my fave of the day.
Yeah, I think you knew that at the time.
Yeah.
You're like, yes. For me, it was probably the one I took of the worker. The portrait,
yeah.
Of the guy doing the... What were they doing? Digging or something?
They were digging out, yeah, like putting in pipes or something.
Because I was trying to like get him in action, like doing the actual movement. But then there was just this moment when he just turned and looked directly down the lens of the camera, like he just looked straight at me.
Yeah.
And that was like one of my favorites.
It seems to happen so much when you're taking a portrait of somebody. Well, if you're standing there with a camera for a few minutes, it's...
they'll probably notice.
It's probably gonna happen, yeah. But when they do look at you, it just makes the picture so much better.
It's kind of funny though, because you're always more drawn to the technical aspects of pictures. So you like when a photo is technically good, whereas I'm more drawn to the pictures that are like, you know, like portraits or somebody's face, somebody's eyes, something that kind of tells a story.
It's just more what we try, I think. You try more of those, I try more of the other ones. So yeah, it's good to get a little mix, but those are our two favorites of today. And I think we'll probably do this in all our little photo vlogs that we do, but hopefully you guys enjoyed that one. We did actually use our Icy preset on that one, the Icy Extra one, which is in our preset pack, just because when we go out and do these photo vlogs and POVs, we're trying to capture the vibe of that day. It was a very bright day. It wasn't golden hour. Towards the end it was a little bit, but the sun was very harsh, there was a lot of shadows, and we just thought that one kind of fits the vibe a little more, kind of a little more bluish tones to it. But that's the preset we used for that one. If you do want to grab our presets, the link will be in the description. The Magantine's preset pack, and we use it on all our pictures.
Hope you enjoyed this video, guys. We had fun just going around once again taking pictures here in the Philippines.
Sure did.
If you liked it, do give it a big thumbs up. We would really appreciate that. Helps us, helps this video. And if you haven't done so already, hit that subscribe button down below. We are pushing for 25k.
Also, turn on the little bell, hit the little notification button so that you don't miss our videos, and you're the first one to see them, first one to like, possibly the first one to comment. Anyway, before it gets windier, I think that'll do it.
And if you disagreed with our choices, let us know if you have a different picture from this video that you preferred.
Yeah. And now we need to go and finish this because it's actually going up today. So, as we always say, take it easy.
Don't be a stranger.